Aladdin Creations.
Hello friends, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kamindu. So today in this video I'm going to discuss with you all about red blood cells. So how these major cellular components of blood are synthesized, destroyed and adapted structurally and functionally to optimize their function, we'll discuss in this video. Erythropoiesis. The process of red cell synthesis is known as erythropoiesis. In adults, it takes place in sites like bone marrow of long bones, pelvis, and sternum. Decreased oxygen delivery to tissues stimulates secretion of erythropoietin from the kidney, which is hormone that regulates late stages of erythropoiesis. The early stages are regulated by integumentary and stem cell factor. Erythropoiesis starts from the stem cell in bone marrow. They pass several stages of cell division differentiation to generate normoblast. With each of these steps, the size and cellular content decrease. Normoblasts lose their nucleus when they differentiate into reticulocytes. We call them reticulocytes because they contain mRNA reticulum which codes for hemoglobin. It disappears when they mature into erythrocytes as the last step of erythropoiesis. Structure and function. On average, the mature erythrocyte measures 7.5 micrometers in diameter and 2.5 micrometers in height. They have biconcave shape, which gives them this pale color appearance in the middle third when you look at them under microscope. This shape increases the effective area available for oxygen diffusion. The shape is maintained with the support of cytoskeleton made of various proteins, but at the same time they let the cell to be flexible, which allows red blood cells to squeeze through tiny capillaries. A red cell usually contains about 270 million hemoglobin molecules. Hemoglobin is a quaternary structure protein which made up 4 peptide chains and 4 iron atoms. They can carry up to 4 oxygen molecules. When it is bound to oxygen, it gives these cells the characteristic red color. Adaptations. Red blood cells transport oxygen and carbon dioxide. They have several unique characteristics which help them to carry out this function effectively. Unlike other cells in human body, they do not contain mitochondria, which means their only means of energy production are glycolysis and HMP shunts. Although these processes are less efficient compared to aerobic respiration, they do not use oxygen, which is a huge advantage in effective oxygen transportation. If the carriers themselves lose the oxygen, tissues would get hypoxia, right? In addition, they lack nuclei and other cell organelles such as the endoplasmic reticulum, which save a lot of energy and space, which will again be utilized for carrying hemoglobin. Destruction. After entering the circulation, the red cell have a lifespan of 120 days. When they get old, diseased or dysfunctional, macrophages in the reticuloendothelial system will engulf them and break them into pieces. Hemoglobin inside them is degraded into heme and globin parts. Protease enzymes then degraded globin chain into amino acids, which gets recycled to help in protein synthesis. The heme components get degraded into bilirubin and iron. Iron ends up as hemosiderin and bilirubin get metabolized in the liver and later excreted in bile.
Well friends, I hope you guys enjoy this video and gain knowledge about these red blood cells. Now you can find this video script from our website www.aladdincreations.com. I hope to discuss disease condition associated with these red blood cells in my upcoming videos. So don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.